Hello, everyone. Welcome to Radio Nyra. Today, we are here with a very special guest, Dr. Rajakumar Thotakura, who is the chairman of Sri Venkateswara Temple, North Carolina, and a psychiatrist by profession in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, and affiliated with multiple hospitals in the Triangle area. And he has been in the practice more than 20 years now. Rajakumar Garu, welcome to Radio Nyra.
Thank you, and Vani Garu. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. Would you please share with our listeners about you and your association with the Sri Venkateswara Temple in Cary, North Carolina?
As you said, my name is Rajakumar Thotakura. I'm a practicing physician in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, more than 27 years now. I've been associated with the Sri Venkateswara Temple of North Carolina since 1999, and I have been the trustee of our SV temple since 2000. So this is my last year of being trustee, and also I'm the chairman of SV Temple of North Carolina now. And I've been very involved in this temple since 1999, and I'm a strong supporter of the temple.
Right. That's good to know, Dr. Rajakumar Garu. So when the SV temple has started, it used to be in a very small building in a very crowded, not so crowded area. So the expansion was remarkable over the years. And can you please share the series of the developments that has happened over the years?
Surely. To give us a little bit of background, in I think just before 1988, there are about six Indians, they had a Vedic priest fund. They initially started that fund. And then in 1998, they acquired 2.5 acres of land on the Chapel Hill Road. As you said, it was not that big, busy area at the time. Now you can see that it's the center of the Cary and a very busy area. And so their humble beginning started with the 2.5 acres. And then that Vedic priest fund, they incorporated the SV Temple of North Carolina in 1998. And that's when they started the small temple. And then over the years, they acquired all the properties surrounding area. Whenever those were available, they bought them. And then now SV Temple of North Carolina has 16 acres of land.
Wow.
And then in 2009, we built the main temple and we did that Prana Pratishta. And then after that, now we're building a Rajagopuram. And we are inaugurating the Rajagopuram coming Monday on Diwali day on October 24th.
Absolutely. It's a very good news to us. And now that you have shared about Rajagopuram, could you please let us know the significance of the Rajagopuram and what are the events planned on the inauguration day, that too special day, which we are going to celebrate a grand Diwali on that particular day?
Sure. Let me just give a little bit of information about Rajagopuram. Mm-hmm. You know, this Rajagopuram that we built now, it is 87 feet tall Rajagopuram. It's a seven-story building.
Wow.
And this is the tallest Rajagopuram that's been built in North America. So we're very proud of that. And just to say a little bit of significance of Rajagopuram, you know, when you finish Rajagopuram construction, symbolically, you finish the construction of the whole temple. What that means is the main temple, you can imagine Lord laying down. The main temple symbolizes the head of the Lord, and the Rajagopuram symbolizes the feet of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
So once we inaugurate this Rajagopuram, devotees have to walk through the Rajagopuram to go into the main temple. And what that means is when people go in through the Rajagopuram, they pray to Lord's feet and then enter into the main temple. That is the custom. Mm-hmm. And so, as I said, this Rajagopuram, we finished the construction. Now we are planning to open that on coming October 24th, Monday. That happened to be the very auspicious day, that is Diwali. And our own governor of North Carolina, Honorable Roy Cooper, graciously accepted to come and inaugurate. So that inauguration by Governor Roy Cooper is going to be at 3:00. And on that day, and after that inauguration, then we will have a Srivaru and Amavaru Rajagopuram Pravesam. We're doing that at 6:30 p.m. And after that, 7:00, we have a Sahasra Deepalankarana. And then 7:30, we have this Dhanalakshmi Puja, we're doing it. And the day we are finishing the program with a spectacular fireworks on the top of the Rajagopuram at 8:00. So I would like all the community come and join and celebrate with us and be part of these celebrations and obtained blessings from Lord.
Absolutely. I think this year it is going to be a very grand with the Rajagopuram inauguration as well as the Diwali celebration. So I'm sure the community people who are in and around or outside of the Cary, North Carolina, most of the people would be coming there to participate in the event. And Dr. Rajkumar Garu, you being the chairman of SV Temple, you have taken up such a huge project. And would you like to recognize anybody in particular for this, the whole project being completed successfully?
Yes, Cindy. First and foremost, I would like to thank the whole Hindu community for coming forth and helping us in the construction of this temple. And the Hindu community also wanted us to build this temple with no debt. And we promised to the Hindu community that we'll build this temple with no debt. So we're very glad we're able to do that and able to keep the promise for our Hindu community. And the next is I would like to give special thanks to the construction committee. And due to this pandemic, this project took more than intended time. And this construction team worked so hard, headed by Dr. Raj Polavarungaru. I would like to thank his team for making this a huge success. And also, I would like to thank each and every, all the management teams over the years also has contributed to success of this Rajagopuram construction.
Good to know, Dr. Rajkumar Garu. And from being a small building to the expansion so far is humongous. And are there any further expansion plans for the temple?
Yes, and we are so excited to inform the Hindu community that we are taking up another huge project. We already started the process. We are building a 40,000 square foot Kalyana Mandapam. And this 40,000 square feet Kalyana Mandapam is going to be a two-storied building in the campus of our temple, 16-acre campus. And in that Kalyana Mandapam, on the upstairs will be Kalyana Mandapam, about 20,000 square feet. And the downstairs will be the cafeteria and also Gurukulam that we have, it will be housed there. And that's a huge project. It's about a $10 to $12 million project. And we already submitted the site plans, and it's in the approval process. I'm hoping that in the next 2 to 3 weeks, we'll get the site plans approved, and then we'll start grading. And hopefully in the next year and a half, we'll have that 40,000 square foot Kalyan Manapam on our campus, which will serve our Hindu community tremendously, like our religious festivities. And also there is a very huge need for our Hindu community for having weddings. So we can perform those wedding ceremonies in our Kalyan Manapam. So we are so excited to start that project. That's a very big and good addition for our temple.
Absolutely, Dr. Rajkumar Garu. And the future plans, whatever you are listed, sounds very exciting. And I'm sure that the community support will be there always, like we had before. And your future plans will be supported as well. And finally, do you want to share anything with our viewers and listeners on Radio Nyra?
Yeah, I would like to thank you first for you and Vani Garu giving me the opportunity to speak to Hindu community. And I would like invite to everybody to come and enjoy the Diwali celebrations and the inauguration of Rajagopuram on October 24th, Monday at 3:00. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rajkumar Garu. And Radio Nyra page also have all the event details that are planned for October 24th. Please do visit and look at the events and do not miss this event, as this is going to be the inauguration and also Diwali celebrations both on the same day. So it's going to be huge and very colorful. And thank you for joining with us and sharing all the valuable information, Dr. Rajgaru. And thank you.
Thank you.